Hi everyone. Today in this video we are going to discuss about dexamethasone. What is this drug dexamethasone? The suffix "-sone" indicates this drug belongs to the glucocorticoid category. Being a glucocorticoid, this drug acts as anti-inflammatory agent as well as immunosuppressant. And here the suffix "-sone" indicates this drug is a cortisone derivative. With few of the structural modifications which are again indicated within the name, the prefix dexa indicates it is having an alpha configuration, and the infix metha indicates it's having the methyl group. So dexamethasone is having the methyl group at the 16th position with alpha configuration. So this drug is a cortisone derivative with 16 alpha methyl group, and it is also having further modifications of the structure which increase the glucocorticoid activity along with little increase in the mineralocorticoid activity. So it is having an extra double bond at first position. Similarly, it is having the fluoro group at the 9th position, which further increase the mineralocorticoid activity. So dexamethasone is a potent drug compared with the cortisone with increased glucocorticoid activity along with little mineralocorticoid activity. So now this dexamethasone can be used in the various conditions as an anti-inflammatory agent as well as immunosuppressant. So this drug can be indicated for the treatment of ulcerative colitis, similarly rheumatoid arthritis, and even any ocular inflammatory disorders such as allergic conjunctivitis, and even the cancer such as multiple myeloma, and in the allergic conditions such as atopic dermatitis. In all these conditions, dexamethasone can be used as a glucocorticoid, which reduce the inflammation as well as suppress the immunity. But as with the more number of clinical uses, this drug is also having a more number of side effects. So dexamethasone can affect the renal system such that it can alter the renal functionality. So one of the impact is that it can reduce the serum potassium levels, resulting in the hypokalemia. Similarly, this drug can increase the risk of thrombosis and thromboembolism, which may lead to some cardiovascular disorders. Similarly, dexamethasone can affect the gastrointestinal system, resulting in the increased ulceration and perforation. It can also affect the eye, resulting in the glaucoma and cataract. Finally, it can also affect the bones, resulting in the osteoporosis. So this drug is having multiple clinical uses as well as multiple side effects affecting the different types of organs. So there should be a sensitive balance between use of this drug and control of side effects. So whenever this drug is required, it can be used as an anti-inflammatory agent and immunosuppressant at a low dose in order to minimize these side effects. During the COVID-19 infection, immune response can be inappropriately activated, resulting in the release of cytokines, leading to cytokine storm, which produce pulmonary inflammation and systemic inflammation. So such condition can be controlled by dexamethasone, where it reduces the inflammatory response by reducing the immune stimuli. But again, at this condition, it may increase the various side effects on the different organs. So care should be taken when this drug is prescribed to control cytokine storm. Now let us the chemical nature of this drug. So dexamethasone is a steroidal anti-inflammatory agent. It is having the steroidal nucleus just like the cortisone, and here it is having the C21 steroidal nucleus. This is the numbering. This C21 nucleus is nothing but the prignane. Now this prignane is having the double bonds at first position as well as fourth position, and ketone groups at third and 20th position. So we can write this as prignane 1,4-diene-3,20-dione. Then if we identify the further groups attached at the different positions, 9th position fluoro group is there, 9 fluoro. Hydroxyl groups are present at 11th position, 17th position and 21st position. So 11, 17, 21 trihydroxy. Methyl group is present at the 16th position by alpha configuration. So 16 alpha methyl. That is a complete name of dexamethasone. Now let us see how this drug acts. Being a glucocorticoid, dexamethasone acts on the glucocorticoid receptors which are expressed within the cytoplasm. So this is the glucocorticoid receptor, which is associated with few of the proteins HSP90, heat shock protein 90. Now when these glucocorticoid receptors are activated, they can target the DNA within the nucleus. Dexamethasone can cross the cell membrane and it can bind to this glucocorticoid receptors present in the cytoplasm. By this binding, glucocorticoid receptor enters into the nucleus where HSP90 is going to be removed. And within the nucleus, this glucocorticoid receptor undergo dimerization, which interacts with the DNA, resulting in the gene transcription. And this gene transcription produces a mRNA. This mRNA is responsible for release of few of the mediators which control the inflammatory response. Now, this mRNA can undergo the protein synthesis, which release few of the proteins such as lipocortin 1 as well as annexin A1. In this way, few of the mediators are going to be released by action of this dexamethasone. At the same time, this drug can block the gene transcription of few of the mediators such as IL-2. IL-2 is one of the important mediator responsible for the immune response. So, synthesis of such mediators and other cytokines is inhibited by dexamethasone. Similarly, few of the inflammatory mediators can act on their corresponding receptors. So, when they are binding to their receptors, they can release few of the inflammatory mediators such as NFKB, nuclear factor kappa B, which can interact with the DNA to increase the gene transcription and release of various inflammatory mediators. Now, this glucocorticoid receptor, which is associated with dexamethasone, can interact with this NFKB. So, it can inhibit the NFKB activity, thereby it can inhibit the synthesis of inflammatory mediators. In this way, dexamethasone can promote the gene transcription of anti-inflammatory agents and it can suppress the gene transcription of inflammatory mediators. So, during the inflammatory stimuli, one of the enzymes that is going to be activated is the phospholipase A2. This phospholipase A2 is a cleavage enzyme. It can cleave the phospholipid membrane such that it can release a C20 fatty acid, which is nothing but arachidonic acid. This arachidonic acid can be converted into various types of mediators and it can be converted into prostanoids by COX pathway. When this COX enzyme acts on this arachidonic acid, it can release the different types of prostaglandins such as PGE2, PGI2 and thromboxane A2. All these are responsible for inflammatory cascade. Now, dexamethasone is going to stimulate one of the enzyme, annexin A1, which can act on this phospholipase A2, thereby inhibits its activity. So, when this enzyme is inhibited, it can inhibit the synthesis of inflammatory mediators. Similarly, dexamethasone can also inhibit the gene transcription that is related with the COX enzyme. In this way, this drug can control the inflammatory response at the nuclear level as well as at the molecular level. What are the precautions? One of the important precautions of dexamethasone is that this drug can affect the renal functionality. So, altered renal functionality is one of the important effects of dexamethasone. By use of this drug, it can increase the excretion of few of the elements such as potassium as well as calcium. So, dexamethasone can reduce the serum potassium levels resulting in the hypokalemia. Similarly, it can reduce the serum calcium levels resulting in the hypocalcemia. But other electrolytes such as sodium and water are going to be retained. So, dexamethasone can increase the serum sodium levels resulting in the salt retention and hypertension. And it can also increase the water levels within the serum resulting in the fluid retention. So, dexamethasone, because of increased serum sodium and water levels, it can increase the blood pressure. So, care should be taken in the patients who are already having elevated blood pressure or fluid retention. Similarly, this drug can affect the bones, resulting in the increased osteoporosis as well as osteonecrosis. This is particularly observed because of effect of this drug on calcium levels. Dexamethasone can reduce the calcium absorption as well as increase the calcium excretion. It can also increase the protein catabolism as well as reduce the estrogen production. All this can increase the risk of osteoporosis. Particularly in the postmenopausal women, the risk of osteoporosis is more pronounced with use of dexamethasone. Another effect is observed on the eye. This drug can increase the risk of cataracts as well as glaucoma. So, intraocular pressure may be increased with use of dexamethasone. But this effect is observed when this drug is used for greater than 6 months. Sometimes it can also produce damage to the optic nerve. And since this drug is going to reduce the immunity, it can increase the infections such as herpes simplex infections, which can further produce damage to the optic nerve. So, care should be taken to check visual acuity as well as any development of herpes simplex infections. Similarly, this drug can increase the risk of ulceration as well as perforation. So, in the patients already having the peptic ulcers, diverticulitis, inflammation of the colon, non-specific ulcerative colitis, this dexamethasone can further increase the ulceration as well as perforation. Similarly, dexamethasone can also affect the muscle. It can produce some myopathy, leading to muscle pain and muscle weakness. And this drug can also produce the mood change in the patients, resulting in the euphoria, hallucinations, and some insomnia. And finally, because of immunosuppression, this drug can increase the risk of infections. So various types of bacterial, viral, and fungal infections can be increased with this dexamethasone. And this is possible when this drug is used at a high dose for a prolonged period. So this drug can increase the risk of viral infections such as varicella zoster infection, which produces the chickenpox. Similarly, hepatitis B infection, otherwise any fungal infections, they can be increased by this dexamethasone. Similarly, dexamethasone can increase the risk of thromboembolism. What are the side effects? As we have seen that this drug can produce effects on different types of organs. So it can affect the gastrointestinal system, resulting in abdominal pain and distension, pancreatitis, some ulcerative esophagitis can be observed with this drug. And it can also elevate the blood glucose levels, resulting in hyperglycemia, increased fluid retention resulting in the edema, and decreased potassium levels resulting in the hypokalemia, headache, vertigo, glaucoma, cataracts, myopathy, muscle pain, osteoporosis as well as osteonecrosis. Some allergic reactions can be observed, and it can also suppress the HPA axis, resulting in the symptoms associated with Cushing syndrome. How it is given? This drug is available as tablet as well as solution. The dose of the drug depends on the type of clinical indication. It can be given at different doses such as 0.75 mg to 9 mg. So it should be started at low dose. But when this drug is going to be stopped, it should not be stopped suddenly. So suppose this is the dose that is going to be maintained, then the dose should be slowly reduced and they should be given twice daily. Then further dose should be reduced and these doses are given once daily. And finally, the drug can be withdrawn from the regimen. In this way, by slow tapering of the dose, we can reduce side effects of dexamethasone as well as immunosuppressant activity. We can also reduce the Cushing syndrome developed in the patients. So that's about this drug, dexamethasone, which is a 9-fluoro substituted 16-alpha methyl cortisone derivative. This drug acts as anti-inflammatory agent as well as immunosuppressant. So it is used for different types of clinical conditions which are associated with excessive immune activity or inflammatory response. It can be used in ulcerative colitis, rheumatoid arthritis, allergic conjunctivitis, atopic dermatitis, multiple myeloma. In many of these clinical disorders, dexamethasone can be used. But at the same time, it can affect the different organs, resulting in the various side effects. It can affect the renal system, resulting in the hypokalemia, hypocalcemia, increased salt and water retention. It can affect the bones, resulting in osteoporosis. It can affect the eye, resulting in glaucoma and cataracts. It can increase the ulceration and perforation of the GI tract. It can also increase the risk of infections such as viral, bacterial, and fungal infections. So that's about this drug dexamethasone. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.